Okay, in this part of lesson, we're going through the operators I sorted on the workflow. You know already most of them, but I just want to make a short description. First operator is cache. Basically, it's very similar to the cache top, both from interface, from parameters, but for my experience, it works a bit strange, so I didn't manage to really prefill the data, but you can go in negative index and including the blend positions, you can even blend shapes in between the frames. I cannot say too much about that. Convert. Well, that's one of the basic TouchDesigner SOP operators where you can convert geometry from all types or from any of particular types. That's a very hidden feature, because if you have a flow containing in the same moment like mesh and let's say if I make a sphere and make that sphere the primitive type, then merge that guys together, then I can convert, for example, only spheres. So then the mesh will be still mesh and the primitive type sphere will be converted to polygons, for example. Then also very interesting option that you, let's make another sphere and let's convert it. So if you convert to polygons, you can convert rows, columns, and that way you can create sections. That's also an interesting option. And last thing I would say, so here you even have the level of details by U and V directions, which is maybe works better by using spline geometry on input. And here the row and columns work even better. Then another thing you can do, let's make a polygon sphere. This is the easiest way to make the points renderable if you just take a geometry and convert it to the particles. And here I can convert two particles, and there are two options, particle per vertex and particle per point. Let's choose particle per point, and then you can decide if you want to render them as lines or as a point sprite. So let's take a point sprites, and then you just input it to geometry, apply the point sprite shader, make a camera and render, and voila, you have rendered points. This is the easiest way to convert any geometry to the renderable point type. In and out is a typical context input output for making inputs and outputs and any of containers and bases. Material is not really usable in TouchDesigner, so that way you can assign material on the SOP level, but because you don't have here the group parameter, like for example in Houdini, you would have in material SOP option to assign material to particular primitive group. And in TouchDesigner, that option is not existing, so that operator is completely not usable because it's much faster to assign material on the object level. Merge is actually nothing to say. You just can merge amount of operators. Or what is interesting, you can drop any operators to the SOP parameter. I think you can even drop here the line of more names and it will merge, so you can not only use the direct inputs but also generate that programmatically, which is very powerful option. And very similar operator is object merge, where you can merge more SOPs by adding that SOPs parameter, and it can even apply some transformation from other geometrical object. Select is quite similar to merge, so I will group that two guys together. Using select, you can select the SOP geometry by name. Sort is interesting. Let's make a grid, for example. Let's make it polygonal. And now if I display options and number of primitives, we can see how that sort operator works for primitives. So I go to primitive, then I can sort by X, sort by Y, sort by Z, sort by type, reverse sorting, make random sorting. Here I have a seed parameter. That is a very powerful option. I can shift the numbering. So you can see then the numbers will be offsetted by 9. You can make it by proximity to point, which is also a very powerful option. You can make it along some vector. And by distance to object. For points, you have the same options. In addition, you have by vertex order and by closest neighbor. And for particle, yeah, there are quite similar options. So, for example, if I use that random sorting, then I can just delete operators, delete primitives by numbers and by range, and just using the standard parameters and changing the seed, you can generate very nice patterns. In addition to merge, select, and object merge, you have a switch, which is a standard TouchDesigner switch between different inputs. You have transform operator, which can apply all transforms on the SOP level. So basically, it's completely the same parameters like every of 3D objects has in XForm page. Almost completely the same, avoiding the path, but it's applied on the SOP level. So that way you can transform particular components, but it works logically much slower. So it's preferable to use the geometry transformation than possible. And last very strange operator is Tristrip. So let's make a sphere geometry. Let's make it polygon and then input it to Tristrip. Then it converts it to the special geometry type called triangle strips, which is renderable directly by OpenGL. Basically, in TouchDesigner documentation somewhere is written that Tristrip should be faster rendered, but I don't, fairly to say, see a huge difference. So that's all about workflow. That's all for today. Thank you for being with us and following our work. And next lesson, we're going to speak about the spline geometry and some specific modeling operation we have in TouchDesigner for that. And please follow our social network and subscribe to our newsletters on website, so you will be always up to date about our new lessons, workshops, etc. Thank you. Bye-bye.